Wayne Couzens admitted to murder, a picture of the reality behind the respectable image has slowly developed. Should his previous behaviour have triggered a warning? And could he have been stopped?
My name's Dal Babu. I'm a former chief superintendent in the Metropolitan Police. We know that he was had indecently exposed himself on at least two occasions. These are often trigger offences for more violent offences against women.
My name is Mark Freestone, and I'm a reader in mental health. Exposing yourself, saying, look at me, I demand that you engage with me as a sexual being, suggests a level of toxic masculinity. And I think there was also some suggestion from Couzens' colleagues in the police force that he was viewed as somebody who had quite an entitled attitude towards sexual contact with women.
Couzens is a married dad of two, but had an online dating profile in a different name, claiming he was single.
What makes somebody a killer? What makes them get to that point?
This former friend of Wayne Couzens told us in the summer that perhaps his past relationships should have raised an alarm.
At the time, he would have been 23, and when they started their relationship, his girlfriend would have been around about 14. It was almost kind of creepy behaviour. He wasn't violent in any way, he wasn't disrespectful in any way, but he was dating a girl that was significantly younger than him.
When he was first arrested, Couzens claimed a gang forced him to abduct Sarah to pay off money he owed prostitutes.
They told me why I need to go and pick up girls and get them to them.
It was a lie, but the debt was real. Couzens owed $29,000.
Your debt is a significant factor when you become a police officer. That's one of the questions you ask.
All of these factors on their own wouldn't be sufficient to suggest that somebody was at risk, high risk of a serious offence. But when you put them together, you actually are looking at somebody who fits the profile of somebody who may be at very, very high risk of committing a crime.
Which all poses some tough questions for the police.
You know, I feel deeply, deeply ashamed that this individual was a member of an organisation that I was a member of. This is the Stephen Lawrence moment around gender issues and the violence that there is against women.